many of you love interaction with IVR? Okay. How many of you hate interaction with IVR? Okay. Some people didn't raise their hand. Looks like they have love-hate relationship with IVR. Yeah. Okay. Just to tell you one incident, last October 2013, okay, I was watching TV with my son, Gautam, he's 6 years. And my washing machine, okay, IFB, which was working flawlessly for 6 years, broke down, okay, and the washing machine, we have to get it repaired. Unfortunately, I didn't have their number because it didn't give any problems for 6 years, okay. So I had to kind of like search everywhere, find the number, call them. I get a very nice, sweet female voice. Yeah, and that too robotic. Unfortunately, yeah, I had to kind of like, first I was happy and then this is a robotic voice. So I kind of like had to, okay, listen to it, okay, and then asking me a number, okay. So basically I'm doing this. And then, okay. In between, my son is coming and disturbing me and I'm saying, wait. Very busy here, yeah. So we listen to IVR so intently that we don't listen to our spouses also. Yeah. We have to look very, very attentive. Keep listening to it. Yeah. So almost at the same time, my Sony TVs, Sony Bravia TVs display also broke. Okay, so I had to call them. Now their IVR was even more horrible. Can't tell them. So I had to kind of like call them at least 10 times to get my TV repaired. Yeah. And every time I was calling them, I was getting irritated with this robotic female voice. Okay. Then I went to office, okay, discussed with my colleague Ravi, Ankush and Vivek. They were all facing the same issue. Okay. But interacting with the IVR is a very, very problematic stuff. I thought, okay, let's do something about it. Okay. And that's when the idea of Breeze came into picture. Okay, so Breeze is basically for easier IVR interaction. Yeah, I hope everyone is able to see the screen. Yeah. So just to demonstrate the capability of Breeze, I'd like one volunteer from the audience. Preferably female with a very nice, natural voice. Yeah. But no, anything is okay. Anyone who is, anyone who is traveling in the near future, who has a waiting list in a PNR or something, waiting list in a train? No? Or anyone who wants to come up on stage? Yeah? Yeah, please, come on. anyone, okay. No? Nobody wants to? Come on, yeah. Shall I pick a volunteer? Yeah. Why don't you come along? Yeah? Thank you. Yeah, Bhavana. First of all, yeah, thanks to you, Bhavana. Looks like you are the only male. Yeah. Okay, so what we are going to do is we are going to probably find the PNR status. Okay, so we are going to call IRCTC and find out our PNR status. Yeah, since no one has probably, no one has told me that they are traveling, I have one PNR number, so I'll tell both of them. Okay, Ravi is using a Breeze app to get the PNR status. Bhavana is going to use her own way of finding the PNR status. Yeah, so we'll see how things go. Okay, shall we start? I'll say 1, 2, 3, and then we'll start. Yeah, okay, 1, 2, 3, start. Yeah, PNR number I'm going to tell when they ask. Yeah? Yeah. 66264. Six three seven double six. Anna, whenever you want number, you just tell me, yeah?
And I took that down.
Yeah. Namaskar.
quickly push that press 1 to know about PNR state. Please enter your 10-digit P. For passenger number 1, status is waiting list 28. Please note that chart has not been prepared for this train.
I'm still calling.
Where are you, Bhavana?
I'm calling now.
You're calling now? Thank you. Yeah.
I can cut the call, right?
Yeah, you can cut the call, please. Yeah. Thanks a lot. Yeah. Thank you. I'm always, I'll get a guy, okay, who's like really fast in checking the PNR status. Yeah, till now it has not happened, so it's fine. Yeah, it's fine. Okay, cool. So you got the idea. So basically what we are doing is we are making the IVR interaction very simple and easy for users. Okay? So you don't have to listen, then type the number, listen and type the number. You can actually browse the IVR. Yeah? It's as if like you are doing a time pass, like a Facebook check or something. Okay, you can browse the IVR. Like you can figure out, or you can try to see what is there in Vodafone IVR. Let me see. So you can actually do that because it doesn't initiate a call until you select call. Yeah. So let's just show an example of SBI. So SBI tree, okay? I'm pretty sure that there might be some people here who have account on the SBI, okay? So if you see their IVR tree, okay, you'll have to go and let's say right now I'm applying for a home loan and I want to check what is the home loan rate, yeah? So let's see what's the process for applying or getting to know the home loan rate, yeah? So this is the first screen, yeah, move on. Yes, okay. So it asks for your debit card, credit card number, okay, and then you go into, you choose something. So imagine just listening to this, yeah? Press 1 for products, services, and all that stuff. So you just keep browsing the IVRs, okay? And when you are happy, you will choose a proper option, yeah? Looks like I took more time than the app, yeah. Okay, but the thing is that, yeah. So it'll dial all the intermediate options for you. We have around 100 companies now, okay? So in 20 categories, you can browse their IVR options. You can bookmark them. So you can actually bookmark the IVR option, not just the number. So every time, let's say you keep checking the same option. So you can bookmark, we call it as one touch IVR option. So in one touch, you can reach that IVR option, okay? Thank you, that was a brief thing about it's called Breeze app, okay, breezeapp.co or Breeze. Looks like the name Breeze is very popular. Whoever wants to get their app as a super hit app, I think they name their app as Breeze. So there are a lot of apps that are called Breeze. If you can search for Breeze and space SimPragma, which is the name of the company, then you will get it. I'd request you guys to install, try it out, okay, bookmark your own options. Okay, I have bookmarked all Sony, IFB, everything, yeah, whatever I have. And please spread the word to your friends. Yeah? Thanks a lot.